This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to talk about continuous and discontinuous functions. Let's start with continuous functions. We say that a function is continuous if we can sketch its entire graph without ever picking our pencil or a marker up from the paper. So this function, for instance, would be a continuous function. I can sketch it from one end to the other without ever picking my marker up from the pencil, from the paper. Okay? So if I have to pick my pencil up or my marker, then we say the function is discontinuous. This graph, for instance, would be discontinuous. It's beginning at negative 5, and it goes on. Let's say it continues up until negative 2, and then there's a gap in it. And it continues after negative 2. Maybe it goes up to positive 4. So because I had to pick my marker up when we got to that gap, where x equaled negative 2, we say that this function is discontinuous. Now, we might be asked to determine the intervals over which this function is continuous. In other words, there were two stretches where I was able to keep drawing without picking my marker up. They went from negative 5 up until negative 2, and then continued again from negative 2 to positive 4. But I never included negative 2 in either of those intervals. So I can describe this using interval notation. I can start out with a square bracket and then a negative 5. The square bracket is saying that negative 5 is included in this first interval. I'll put in a comma, and then a negative 2, and then I'll finish it off with a round parentheses, showing that we're going up to negative 2, but not quite reaching it. And then it picks up again. It starts up again after negative 2. So I'll use a round parentheses. And it continued up to and including 4, positive 4. So I'll put in this 4 and a square bracket. So I can say that there are two intervals over which the function was continuous, from negative 5 to negative 2, and then from negative 2 up until 4. Here's another example of kind of a discontinuous function. Let's say that once again I start at negative 5, maybe down here. And I continue up to negative 2, and in fact I include negative 2. And then I jump up along that vertical line where x equals negative 2. I jump up to here and begin again just after negative 2, and continue on to infinity. So obviously this was not a continuous function. It was discontinuous because I had to pick my marker up when I got to negative 2. It had two continuous intervals. The first interval went from negative 5, including negative 5, so that's a square bracket, and it went up to negative 2 and included negative 2. So that once again is a square bracket. After that, it started just after negative 2, so I'll use a round parentheses, and it continued forever up to infinity. So that's infinity, and with infinity we always use parentheses because we never quite reach infinity. Okay, so this was another example of a discontinuous function. We're able to use interval notation to show where it is continuous, the two stretches where it's continuous. Let's look at one more. We might have a function with something called an asymptote, a vertical asymptote. So let's say we have a function that starts at negative infinity and seems to increase and increase and increase, gets bigger and bigger as it approaches positive 2, but it never reaches positive 2. Then it starts up again after positive 2, but it starts up again down towards negative infinity on the y-axis and increases again and continues to positive infinity. So obviously this is a discontinuous function because I had to pick my marker up when I got to 2. The intervals that I can use to show where it's continuous would be from where it began, negative infinity, that's with a round parentheses, up to but not including positive 2, and then it begins again after 2 and goes on to positive infinity. Okay, so the basic concepts are fairly simple. If you can sketch the graph without ever picking your pencil or your marker up, then you've got a continuous graph. If you have to pick your pencil or your marker up, then it's discontinuous. You can show the stretches, the intervals over which it's continuous, by using interval notation. Okay? And that's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.